really what the robot is trying to do is it's trying to take the person's perspective and what is a person feeling during assistance. When the robot's doing this, it's actually using what it feels on its fingertips. So it's saying, given what I feel on my fingertips, or it's my gripper, what do I think a person is feeling while being dressed? From the robot's perspective, it's thinking, if I move this way, if I move this way, if I try a different way, how will that impact a person? How is that going to apply force onto a person when I'm helping them, say in this case, pull on a hospital gown? And so the robot tries these different ways, predicts into the future, how does this action going to affect a person? Is it going to apply a lot of force? Is it going to be more comfortable or less comfortable? And then using all this information, using these predictions, it tries to select an action that's, say, best for the person.
When I go and I help someone, I can draw on that experience, those years of dressing myself. I have a sense of what it's like, what it feels like, what to do, what not to do. But robots haven't had the benefit of that experience. So through the simulation, the robot can get some of that same type of experience, because it not only is simulating the cloth, it's simulating the person. And it has this window into what the person is feeling.